Hi, let's start data structure chapter 3, that is linked list. So I already cover array and stack and queue, its lecture plus its previous 10-year question. So if you have not visited, just go through that. So next we'll start linked list. So in linked list we'll cover singly linked list, circular linked list, doubly linked list and doubly circular linked list. So linked list, so this is a picture of linked list. So you can see it is a collection of nodes. So this is a node that have two part. One is data, another is address. So it don't hold the address of its own, it hold the address of next node. So like here you can see this is the data is 3 and the address part is 200. 200 means it holds the address of next node. Okay, address always in hexadecimal format, but for my example, for simplicity, I'm just taking 100, 200, 300. Address always in hexadecimal format. Okay, so then an extra pointer that holds the address of first node. Like here, this is extra pointer. This is not a node, this is a pointer that holds the address of the first node. So this is your first node, its address is held by this pointer. This pointer can name head, first or anything like our. And last node address part is null. This is null because it is not pointing to anything, so it is null. So, and it is in non-contiguous manner. So in memory it don't store in contiguous manner, it store in non-contiguous manner. Like suppose one node is 100, one node is 400, next node is like 300. It can be in any location where space is available. Just you need to add the address of the next node. Array is a contiguous manner. Array store in memory in contiguous, but linked list it store in non-contiguous manner. So it can store in any space, just a link, just the address should be in the previous node. So extra storage required for pointer. Let's take this is a pointer, and for data, suppose it is integer, let integer size is 4 byte. Okay, so integer size is 4 byte, so data is 4 byte, but for the pointer, for the address part, it also store 4 byte, means for a node it require 8 byte. Okay, so 4 byte for data, 4 byte for address also. So that's why it require extra storage, extra memory for the pointer too. Okay, in every node there is a pointer also, and for every node it needs double the data size. And it is of dynamic size, means initially you don't need to specify what will be the linked list length. So it can be increased dynamically, whatever you can insert any number of node. So next is self-referential structure. So in node here, this is a data and this is a pointer. So how to represent one data and one pointer? So we can create a self-referential structure. Like you can use the keyword struct. So struct node, so it create a node, and inside that we can write character data or in data, float data, whatever data type we are taking. And another struct node, then a pointer link. So this will hold the address, like this part. So this is this part. Then end, then a struct node head. So head is a pointer that hold a node, that hold the first node. So that's it. So this is a self-referential structure, basic structure. You can change according to your requirement. So next we'll do one example, that is count number of node in a single linked list. So this is a program int count struct node p first, so that p pointer that hold the first node. Then int count 0 while p means p is not equal to null, p is something, p contains some data. Then plus count, so count value will increment. So initially it was 0, now it will be increment. Then p equal to p link. So this is for the reference, this is for the pointer, the link part. Okay, p implies link. So let's see how this run in this example. Like initially here count equal to 0, so while p means this contains some data, then count value will be 1 and p value will point to here. Then count value will be 2, p value will point to here. Then count value will be 3, but next p value cannot point because this is the null. Okay, So here it will be 3. So it will just count how many nodes present in the linked list. So two type of symbol are used for linked list. One is indirect selector that we use, that is indirect selector. It is a user friendly operator. In maximum question we are using this P implies data. So this arrow mark and data. So this arrow symbol, that is for the indirect selector. Then direct selector, that is represented by a dot. So it is a machine friendly operator. You can write pointer P then dot data. So mainly we are using this symbol P arrow data. Okay. So in lots of program you will see this P while P. P means P not equal to null. While not P means P equal to null. Then P implies link, that means P implies link is not equal to null. Then not P implies link means P implies link equal to null. So just mark this. In the maximum question you will see this. So what is meaning of this? So this next is disadvantage of single link list. So the link part of the last node is not utilized because it is null. But for that null also it is reserving memory, okay? And stepping backward is not possible as it only traverses forward. So stepping backward is not possible. So next, let's do one example, that is print data value of single linked list. So here void main do first. So it will call this function, then do struct node P. So P is a pointer that holds the first node. So then if P print, then character P data, then do P implies link. So first it will, if P means P is not equal to null. So then P data, so first it will print A, then do P link, means it will go to the link part, means it will go to here. Then again it will call from this, if P may, if some data is present, so first it will print B, then it will go to P link, means it will go to C. Okay, then again it will print P data C and go to P link, but here link part is null, so it will stop here. So output will be A, B, C. So this is a tail recursion. So the recursive function is at last line. Suppose it will be a non-tail recursion, then what will be output? Means suppose do statement will be here, do statement will be first, then will be print statement, then what will be output? Just think about this. So just see what will be output. Like suppose first is the do statement, okay, and next is the print statement, okay, then what will be output? So just see. So first do here, it will call here. So whenever it will call, it will use a stack, and in stack it will store the print part. So it will print that C, that A part it will store in a stack, and again it will call the do function. So first it, then it will call the DB part. So whenever it will call that, so it will store print B part in a stack, then it will call the do C. So it will just store print C. So now all the call are done. So now it will pop from the stack. So it will first, it will print C, then B, then A. So what it will doing, whenever it is calling recursive function, so whatever the next line, what it will store in a stack, okay? So that is that in recursive call we use a stack. So whenever it call this function, if it is a non-tail, means if do statement is first, then is print statement. So whatever statement or whatever is written after that call, so it will store in a stack. And then after the all the call finish, it will pop from the stack. So it will give output CBA. If it is a tail recursion, means this statement is last line, then output is ABC. If this is a non-tail recursion, means do is statement is first and print statement is second, then it will print CBA. I think you guys are clear. Okay, so next is difference between array and linked list. So let's explain through some diagram. So this is array and linked list. So cost of accessing an element in array is order of 1. Because in array we have particular location, like A of 3. We know the formula how to find A of 3 location. We can go directly that location and we can assess the data. So the cost of assessing element is order of 1. But in case of linked list, it is order of n. Because the head or the that pointer that hold on only the first address. Okay. So from that we need to traverse. Suppose so you want to access this element or this element, we need to traverse there. So that traversal take order of n. As you cannot directly go to here, the first, the head node, so that only contain the first node address. So that's why for traversal, it is order of n. Then memory utilization in array, it is not efficient, but in linked list, it is efficient. Why not efficient? Because array declaration, that is static. And suppose here, let's just see this example. Oh, we have created an array of size 5. Okay. But we store just 3 value. So suppose integer size is 4 byte, then here it will reserve 20 byte, but we are using just 12 bytes. So next 8 byte is wastage. So that's why it is not utilized, not efficient. So here we just took a 5 array of size 5, but suppose you will take an array of size 50, but you are using just just data of 10. Okay. Then that 40 space is wasted. Okay, so that's why it is not efficient. But here it is efficient as well. How much node is required? You are creating automatically. It is dynamic. So memory allocation is dynamic. But here memory allocation is static because in array it will reserve that space whether you are using or not using. But here whenever you require, it will create for you. So next is cost of insertion or deletion. Let's first discuss cost of insertion. So in array at the beginning, order of n. So suppose you want to insert something at the beginning, then you have to move, you have to shift all the data, and you can insert data here. So for that shifting, it is order of n. And at the end, suppose you want to insert something here at the end, so don't need to shift nothing, so it is order of 1. And at ith position, at middle of anything, then rest of I 2 till n minus 1, you have to move. So that's why it is order of n. So for deletion also, suppose you want to delete this, then you have to move this data to here. So it is order of n. And at the end, suppose you want to delete this, then it will be order of 1. At ith position also, rest of I plus 1 to till n minus 1, you have to move. So that's why it is order of n. So next is for linked list. So linked list insertion at the beginning. Suppose you want to insert a node here, then at the beginning it will be order of 1. Because head is just pointing to this, what you can do, you can just change like here some address, head can point to this and this can point to this. So simply it is order of 1. At the end it is order of n. Why order of n? So the head node that hold the address of the first node. So you need to traverse till end, then here you can insert. Like here it can hold the address of this, and this data will be null, and here suppose some data. So at the end it will be order of n, just for the head, the pointer is pointing to the first node and you are traversing till end. So for that traverse it is order of n. Suppose there is another pointer that pointing to the end, okay, and you want to insert at the end, then it will be order of 1. And at ith position it will be order of n, because you need to traverse till that I position. If some pointer is pointing to that I position, then it will be order of 1. Suppose you want to delete this node, what you can do, you can just point to this, so this will be order of 1, okay. And at n, so suppose you want to delete this, you need to traverse this. For this traverse, it will be order of n. And at ith position deletion, it is order of n for that traverse. Suppose a pointer is pointing to end and you want to delete the end last node, then it will be order of 1. Or suppose a pointer, like suppose you want to delete this, suppose a pointer is pointing to this, about x or anything, suppose a pointer is pointing to this and you want to delete this, then it will be order of 1. Okay, so this order of n, it is just for the traverse, not for the operation. So insertion and deletion that take order of one, but for as there is just one pointer head and you are traversing till that point, so for that it is order of n. I think you guys are clear. So insertion and deletion taking order of one time, but for the traverse we are taking order of n. So if there is just one pointer at that pointing to first node and you want to insert or delete at n, then it will be order of n. And if you want to insert or delete at particular I position, then it will be order of n. If there is another pointer that pointing to that position, then it will be order of one. So next is searching. So searching in array, it can be linear or binary, but in linked list only linear is possible. So we'll do searching in algorithm. So what is linear search, what is binary search, that you will clear there. So next is circular linked list. So circular linked list advantage is last node link part is utilized. So here previously it was null. Okay, but here this part is utilized and stepping backward is possible. So you can traverse backward also. In a singly linked list, it was just forward traverse, but here backward traverse is possible. Then disadvantage, it may fall into infinite loop. So this is a picture of circular linked list. So from the last node, one pointer is pointing to the first node. So it's just creating a circle, that's why circular linked list. So but it may fall into infinite loop and rest all the thing that are same as singly linked list, there is a head pointer that pointing to first node, just changes the last node that link part that is utilized that point to the first node, and we can come backward, like after this we can come again to the start. Okay, so just this is the difference. Next, all the operation are same like singly linked list. So this much is for circular linked list, and next we will do doubly linked list. Thank you.